every man of the house of Israel that set above his face idols in his heart, and put a stumbling block of his iniquity before his face, and cometh to the prophet. I, the Lord, will answer him that cometh according to the multitude of his idols, that I may take the house of Israel in their own heart, because they are awe and strain from me through their idols. Therefore, say unto the house of Israel, thus saith the Lord God, repent, turn yourselves from your idols, and turn away your faces from all your abominations.
It's time to get out of the Christian church. It's time to get out of Catholicism. It's time to get out of Islam. Okay? Kyrie Irving is he's claiming Muslim. Okay? But he's following Kemet. He's confused. But he's still searching. But he don't know. He's following idols, man. He's dealing with idol worshiping. But we gotta pray for him to come all the way home. Okay? But a lot of our people are dealing with these things, man. The Christian church is still it's on life support right now because the Israelites are waking up. The Christian church is on the respirator. Okay? The Christian church got the virus. Okay? They got the damn corona. Okay, go ahead.
For every one of the house of Israel or of stranger that sojourneth in Israel would separate of himself from me and set up idols.
Verse 12,
the word of the Lord God came again unto me, saying, Son of man, when the land sinneth against me,
when the land sinneth against me, go ahead,
by trespassing grievously, then I will stretch out my hand upon it.
Okay, so the Lord is stretching his hand upon it. That's why America's running crazy right now. And in Chicago, they made the mandate for the police officers. So now they got to get the vaccine. And in Chicago, check this out. Hold on now. There's over 200 police officers that's ready to go on strike. Okay? And if, hold on, brother, let me get my thought across. Okay, over 200 police officers ready to go on strike, right? In Chicago, niggas are killing each other left and right. So imagine when them police officers go on strike. Y'all want to defund the police? Always defunding the police, believe it or not, you Negroes need to be policed. The police need to be out here killing a lot of you wicked Negroes. Because you out here killing your brothers. And this is judgment upon y'all. But what's going to happen? This is the Most High's arms reaching this filthy land. Go ahead.
I will stretch out my hand upon it. It will break the staff of bread thereof.
And break the what?
It will break the staff of bread thereof.
He going to break the bread, man. That famine is coming. There ain't going to be no bread, man. Go ahead.
And will send famine upon it.
Ain't going to send famine. That's why you got them damn shipping containers floating in the ocean. What you had to say, brother?
All thing I want to say was, I feel like it's only one God of the universe. It's only one Most High. And I feel like it's a lot of people gangbanging on God. Like they you know, from all that shit. Israelite, from the everybody. It's like they you know, Allah, all the people, they it's like it's a spiritual war.
That's what it is. You know, that's right.
And they sit there gangbanging on God, but it's only one. Why would it be only one God and everybody going against each other?
Because they don't know who that God is. Our people worship many gods.
It's only one.
Right, but we have many idols. That's what we were just reading about, all these idols. Right, Allah is not a god. Allah is a rock. Allah is a rock. Buddha is a fat Chinese man in the back of the Chinese restaurant.
I don't listen to all the names. I don't listen to all the names.
But the God of Israel listens to all those names. And he said they are nothing.
You can say Yahweh. You can say can say Allah, you can say whatever the hell you want to say.
Can we say Satan?
God is only one person.
So we can worship Satan? Call God Satan?
If you want to.
No, you can't. This is the reason why we out here. Because we trying to correct our people. How you going to call God Satan, man? Come on, bro. If you want to. See, that's the problem with our people. Our people think we got free will. That's the thing. Our people think we got free will. If you had free will, guess what? There wouldn't be a punishment for us committing sin, man. There wouldn't be punishment for following other gods.
Right.
Okay? But in India, they was going through the virus over there. They had the coronavirus over there. They started throwing all their idols in the street, man, and running them over. Yeah, we love you too, but you gotta love us with understanding. We love you with understanding. How you gonna say we can call God Satan and we can love Satan?
I didn't say no.
You said if we want to. We got it on video, man.
That's on y'all. If y'all do that.
But that's the point. You can't do that. You can't give the green light to a brother to do that, man.
An individual is a separate person.
You say you love your brother. That's not love.
I love y'all.
But you can't say you love us and you can tell us we can worship Satan if we want to.
That's what I'm gonna do.
No. But that's our job to show people the way. Now, if you choose to do what the hell you want to, that's between you and the Heavenly Father. But the Heavenly Father commanded us to come out here and teach this word. Watch this here. Go ahead.
It's only one.
Ezekiel chapter 3 and verse 18. When I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die.
What are you doing? 15. Where are you going? 14. Oh, now. Squat.
And will cut off man.
Where you at?
Right.
Read again. 13.
Verse 13. Son of man, when the land sinneth against me by trespassing grievously, then will I stretch out my hand upon it, and will break the staff of the bread thereof, and will send famine upon it. It will cut off man and beast from it.
He gonna cut off man and beast. Ain't nobody get exempt from the Most High's judgment, man. Okay? I'ma tell y'all like this. Wait till you start seeing it now. I'ma show y'all something. The animals are about to start getting COVID, man. They gonna start telling you that. And they gonna tell you that the animals in the farms got COVID. And they're not gonna be able to sell them to you. This is happening.
Ring down.
Right, they say the animals in the zoo got it. So imagine when they start hitting the farms. Okay, go ahead.
Dog, these three men, Daniel and Job. These three men, okay? Daniel, Noah, and Job. Hold on, brother. What are you talking about? See, nobody was saying nothing. No rebuttals. You can't make this up, man. I'ma ask you like how was Shy ask the Legion.
Yeah.
What is your name? What is your name? What is your name?
I know it.
What is your name?
I know the book.
Your name is I Know It? What is your name? You see that? You gotta ask these spirits their names, man, because they got names. They got names and titles. Allah is a rock in Mecca, a cobblestone. Well, that's their problem. That's why the Lord is angry and fear and mad with this society.
Right.
Okay? They took his rainbow and polluted it. Okay, go ahead.
We got it
again? Though these three men, Noah, Daniel, and Job, were in it, they should deliver but their own souls by their righteousness, saith the Lord God.
You see, them three men was in it, man. They was in all types of madness, but they was delivered because they kept the faith in the Most High. They kept the commandments in the Most High.
There's only one Most High.
That's right.
That's all I'm saying.
But we can't call them all these names. His name is Yahweh. Yahweh. That's his name.
I know what you're saying.
And that's what we gotta, so that's what we gotta deal with. Yahweh Shai is the Messiah. Go ahead.
Verse 15. If I cause noisome beasts to pass through the land and they spoil it, so that it be desolate, that no man may pass through it.
So now the Most High say he'll send beasts through the land, man. Now I'm gonna show y'all something. Beasts ain't always wild beasts.
Go ahead.
It says beasts that no man should pass through it. They'll make it desolate. Beasts is also these nations, man. Beasts are also our people. You understand? Our people make it. Hold on, brother. Our people make it. Make the elderly, make the children scared to come outside and play, scared to come outside and walk. They make it desolate. Young children don't even want to come outside and play in the playgrounds of Chicago. Atlanta's acting up now too. Atlanta, the murder rate is going up. All the guns is gone. Everybody's getting killed.
Yeah.
And it's happening in New York. It's happening everywhere.
Right.
Bring it out.
This is part of prophecy. The lesson is the Lord stretching his arm against the land for judgment. This is the judgment of God, man. Go ahead.
Verse 15.
What about if
I cause noisome beasts to pass through the land and they spoil it, so that it be desolate, that no man may pass through because of the beast.
Go ahead.
Though these three men were in it, as I live, said the Lord, they shall deliver neither sons nor daughters. They only shall be delivered, but the land shall be desolate.
See that? So even our children might not make it, man. Our children might not make it. Job's children ain't make it. Job's children ain't make it. His wife ain't make it. You understand? So these things can happen. That's why we gotta get our stuff together. This thing ain't for everybody, but the Most High promised deliverance. Deliverance to the righteous, man. There's deliverance to the righteous. So whether your kids are on board, whether your wife is on board, whether your husband's on board, you gotta get your shit together. You gotta get your shit right. And you gotta get righteous with the Lord, man. You can't let nobody stop this here. Okay? Go ahead.
Verse 17, or if I bring a sword upon the land, and say sword go through the land, so that I cut off man and beast from it.
He's telling you he's going to send a sword through this land. And when he does, and he cut off man and beast from it, go ahead.
Though these three men were in it as I live, said the Lord God, they shall deliver neither sons nor daughters.
See that? The Most High is showing you. He keeps going over these three men. Noah, Daniel, and Job, man. They had faith in the Lord. They had faith when nobody else had it. When their family ain't had it. Job's family ain't had that faith. Noah was against the whole damn world, man. The whole world ain't had that faith. But Noah kept it. Okay, Daniel was in the furnace of the fire and ain't get burnt, man. Ain't get burnt, man. Come on now, you interrupted now. That's, and so did Noah, and so did Daniel. And this is where we gotta get our faith to. This is where we gotta step it up to. Yeah, we gotta be like Christ and try to emulate Christ. But these were righteous men that made it also. And they're part of that 144,000, man. Okay, go ahead.
But they only shall be delivered.
They only shall be delivered. So it don't matter how many's up here. You gotta get right with the Most High.
My son named Jeremiah.
Okay,
I got a son named Joshua.
But what does that mean?
My daughter named Layla.
And what does that mean?
My daughter named Layla.
Come on now, you stepping all over. Come on now.
Excuse me. I'm sorry. My daughter named Layla.
Okay.
All my kids got people
today. Yeah, but you gotta be teaching your children.
I am.
All right. I hope so.
That's what he said.
I hope so. All right. What are you teaching your children that? Now it's personal. But you telling everybody your children's names and telling us they all got biblical names, but now it's not. Now, I teach my children the law, statutes, and commandments. I'm teaching them the love of God, man. That's what the law, statutes, and commandments are. That's the love of God. Okay, go ahead. Verse 18. Yeah, verse 18. Though these two men were in it, as I live, saith the Lord, they shall deliver neither sons nor daughters, but they only shall be delivered themselves. Or if I send a pestilence into that land and pour out my fury upon it in blood, to cut off from it man and beast, though Daniel and Job were in it, as I live, saith the Lord God, they shall deliver neither son nor daughter. You see how repetitious the Lord is? You see how repetitious the Lord is? Because he's telling you, you got to keep this faith, man. Like those honorable men, those righteous men that was before us, our forefathers, man. Our forefathers was righteous at one time, but we fell away from grace, man. That's it on that. Give me what you got.
This is 2 Andrew chapter 15, verse 3. Fear not the imaginations against thee.
Fear not the imaginations against thee. You're not supposed to fear the virus. You're not supposed to fear what's going on, these famines. The Most High said, his elect gonna eat, man. We gonna eat. If you pushing this word and you living righteously when nobody's around, you gonna eat, man.
Behold, let not the incredulity of them trouble thee that speak against thee.
Let none that they speak against us, man. Okay, worry us. Okay, just like Kyrie Irving. I don't know if y'all see that man turned down $186 million plus $36 million for this season. How much is $186 million plus $36 million? What's that? 186 plus 36. Somebody do the math real quick. How much is that? 186 plus 36. I'm going to show you. Yeah, but you niggas give it up for $100. You take the vaccine for $100 and a pack of new parts. Some of y'all do it for a Lucy and a nip. Some of y'all do it for a Lucy and a nip. What are you talking about, Willis? You're not getting it. Look. Everything I said went past you into the garbage over there behind you. Everything I said just now. The man turned down 200 plus something million dollars. Where they do that? That's called integrity.
Right.
That's called honorable.
Right.
That's called not being Uncle Tom.
Yeah.
That's called not being a sellout.
Right.
That's what the Most High is looking for.
Bring it
in. He's looking for those type of men.
Yeah.
That's not going to bow the knee to Baal. $224 million, and you niggas give up your butt for a damn contract.
Bring that out.
You give up your ass. You turn to a sodomite for a contract that doesn't even live forever, man. You give up the ghost. You got niggas up here back and forth all through his hood. All right? You give them a damn bag of crack and they'll do any damn thing. A bag of crack and they'll bend over for a white man. They'll let you stick something different in their rear. Niggas sell out for nothing. The Bible say, where's that? Give me that. Look it up where it says, we sell my people for naught in Psalms. What's that? In Psalms 49? Psalms 49. You sell my people for naught. You hold that. Kyrie Irving is standing up and he turned out so much money. And that's why people look at him like he's crazy. But I show you, money can't buy everybody. nobody. So when they say, remember million dollar Ted DiBiase, who was raised on WWF? Million dollar man, Ted DiBiase. His thing was, everybody's got a price. Well, nah, 7,000 men, the Lord said, don't got a price. The Lord said 7,000 men don't got a price. You dig it? Psalms 44 and 12. Give me that real quick. Baba Kashaw. That's what it is, man. Sold my people for nut, man. You niggas sell out for a bag of weed. You got everybody taking. They was giving y'all niggas Krispy Kreme donuts, man. You niggas took the jab for a Krispy Kreme donut. And here go this man, right? And not only 220 something million that he turned down, he also turned down an opportunity to be an NBA champion again. Right, you niggas done gave up, you took the jab for free lap dances, man. A free bag of weed in D.C. Burger, a burger from Five Guys. You see that? But watch what the Most High say. Give me that. This is the book of Psalms, chapter 44, verse 12. Yeah! They'll sell us dead people for nuts. You don't sell the people for nuts, for a Krispy Kreme donut. A Krispy Kreme donut. And a lot of you niggas don't mess with you supposed to be eating that stuff. You're already overweight. You got high blood pressure. All right? You got gout. You got diabetes. But you want to give up the, you want to take a jab for a damn Krispy Kreme donut. And look at what the Most High did to Shaq's Krispy Kreme donuts in Atlanta. He burnt that damn thing down twice. Yeah! He burnt that thing down twice. I don't know if y'all paying attention to the Lord. I don't know if y'all paying attention. Okay, go ahead.
It does not increase thy wealth by thy price.
And you don't increase your wealth by your price. You done sold yourself out for a Krispy donut. Krispy Kreme donut, and this man turned down 200 million. You Negroes would have sold your damn children for 200 million. You would have gave your children away. I know you would have. You would have gave your children away. You would have gave your butthole away. All right? You would have did so many strange things for that. What was that show? You did Stranger Things.
Yeah!
For $200+ million. All right? Let's go back to Esdras.
Second Esdras 15 and 4. For all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness.
All the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness. Put your faith in a jab. Then it's not one jab. It's not two jabs. They keep telling you gotta take this damn thing every damn month. Every 3 months. All the goddamn boosters. All these booster shots. Come on, man. Kyrie Irving said, hell no. And he turned out $200 million. Everybody can't be bought. Don't listen to million dollar man Ted DiBiase. Okay? Because Virgil was bought. He had Virgil like the damn... Remember Virgil? Virgil was his damn puppy. Yeah, the black nigga. The only damn nigga following big old Virgil. Goddamn Virgil. Don't be Virgil, man. Don't be Virgil. Alright? Go ahead.
Verse 5. Behold, saith the Lord, I will bring plagues upon the world. The sword, famine.
The Lord said he will bring plagues upon the world, the sword, and famine. That's what we're getting back to. That's the point of this topic. The famine, man. That's what's coming up next. America, you thought America was going crazy over these mandates. When they start not allowing the people to work where they can't get no money for food, and then when they get the vaccines, and then there's no food on the shelves, oh, Jake gonna go crazy, okay? Give me what you got.
Death and destruction. Verse 6.
Death and destruction, go ahead.
For wickedness have exceedingly polluted the whole earth.
For wickedness have polluted the whole earth exceedingly, man. The whole earth, but mainly right here in America. America, this is the home of the gay and the land of the slave, man.
Bring it out.
That's what this is. Ain't no home of the brave. America never been brave. They don't even fight hand-to-hand combat. They press buttons, man. They press buttons. Afghanistan, the Arab will whip America's ass if they don't use no damn airplanes, man. Who was the other ones? The Vietnamese was whipping the white man's ass in the Vietnam War. They was whipping their ass. That's why they had to drop that bomb. That's why they had to drop that bomb. And what was that song? They did a song about that, mocking it, man. They dropped the bomb on us. Right, who made that song? Who? The Gap Band, right. They dropped the bomb on us. Right? And what was that talking about? That was not talking about Hiroshima. That was talking about Black Wall Street. That was talking about Black Wall Street. Imagine if we had the same head start as the white man. The white man be finished, man. The white man be finished. And I'm going to show you how ununified we are. If all the NBA players would have took a stand with Kyrie Irving, all them white, the mandates would have been thrown out the window.
Bring it out.
The mandates would have been thrown out the window. They would have said, yo, that's a $1 trillion business, and ain't nobody coming here to see the white owners.
Bring it out.
They want to see the NBA players. They could have started their own league with Ice Cube, man, and brought everybody over.
Like the ABA.
Right. Like the ABA. The damn Negro League, man. We don't need to be a part of this society. We need to be set apart.
Right.
But y'all don't got enough faith. Y'all don't got the cojones, man. Y'all don't got the balls. The testicular fortitude, like The Rock says. They ain't got no testosterone, man. Y'all ain't got it. You know why? Because you don't know who your power is, man. You don't know where your power come from. You don't know your God. You don't know who you are.
Right.
And that's why you scared to stand up against your oppressor. We need more people like Kyrie Irving, who ain't afraid to say, I'm not doing it. I don't care. And they gonna make him look like he's crazy.
Right.
Look at Dave Chappelle. That man said, I don't care neither. And look how the Most High worked for Dave Chappelle. Most High fired that tranny that tried to start that stuff in Netflix, man. Got that damn transformer fired. When you with the Most High, man, when you move in the spirit of righteousness, the Most High fights your battles. But you don't know about that. You don't got enough faith in the Most High because you live wickedly. You live too wickedly. Okay, give me what finish 8 first. That's 8?
That's 6.
That's 6. It's finished?
No, it's not finished.
Go ahead.
And their hurtful works are fulfilled. Therefore saith the Lord, I will hold my tongue no more as touching their wickedness.
Right. So he's not holding his tongue no more. His tongue is lashing out, spitting fire at you. Okay? Drop down to the 14th verse, Bible Kishar.
Verse 14. Woe to the world and to them that dwell therein.
The Most High said, woe to this world and them that dwell therein. But he's not talking about the elect. The elect are wicked, just like Job, Noah, and Daniel, man. Okay, go ahead.
Verse 15. For the sword and your destruction draweth not. The world people,
wait, the sword and destruction draweth nigh, man. It's inching close up. It's on your ass, America. The Most High sword and destruction is on America's ass. Go ahead.
And one people shall stand up to fight against another.
These are race wars, man. One people shall stand up to fight against another. Which is right where Yahushua said, nation shall rise against nation. This is biblical prophecy. And guess what? When that time comes, you're going to know to be set apart, and you're going to get away from your oppressors. You're going to need the love of your people. It's just a matter of time. Go ahead.
And swords in their hands.
With swords in their hands. Okay? Not no damn machetes. Not no ninja swords. They coming with guns, man.